greet each and everyone in the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We praise God for this wonderful day. It's my privilege, my joy to minister to you through this God's word. So on Sundays, you know, we are studying about healing. This is a third week on healing. Even though I teach about healing so many times, you know, once again, I want to take a time to teach about healing. Because I really care about every brothers and sister who are watching this. And it is God's will that you should be healed. And it is my desire that you should be healed. I want you to experience divine health in your body and divine strength and well-being and peace and shalom in your life. So we are studying about, you know, cause of sickness. You know, it may look like a repetition to you, but I want to say this again and again so that it will sink into your heart. I'm not sharing this, you know, repeating this again and again because I don't have a stuff to share with you. Actually, I'm loaded with a lot of stuff and I study a lot and learn, and there is so much for me to say. But you know what? Without, you know, establishing the basics, you know, going on teaching so many things is not going to work out. So I'm not a kind of a school teacher where I'm trying to finish my syllabus. No. I am a pastor, you know, I am like your spiritual father. I care for you. I want you to get these things in your life. So in Proverbs, you know, 23 verse 7, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. The cause of sickness is, you know, thoughts. See, most of the time we are not dealing with the roots. And especially in English medicines, you know, directly allopathy medicines directly deals with the symptoms, not with the root. That's why sometimes, you know, you cannot able to experience the total healing. It will come back to you again and again. But, you know, if any kind of medicine which deals with the roots, it may take some time. But, you know, you will not get that sickness again and again. So, you know, what I'm going to deal with you right now, we are going to deal with the roots, the cause of sickness. You know, we're going to pluck it from the root so that you will not become sick again and again. There are people who gone into a lot of treatments. They were healed for some time, but again, they got sick. You know why? They were affected by the same sickness. You know why? Because, you know, they have not dealt with the root which brought the sickness in the first place. So as a man thinketh in his heart, so see the thoughts. You know, your thoughts, you know, certain negative thoughts or certain wrong thoughts produce certain negative feelings and wrong feelings. And those feelings, you know, create the certain reality, certain sickness in your life. So once again, I'm going to deal with the thoughts. You should have a right thoughts about God. You should have a right thoughts about you. You should have a right thoughts about others. People have a wrong thoughts. First of all, people have a wrong thoughts about God. They think that God means, you know, you will be keep on giving problem. You'll be keep on giving suffering. You know, they think that Christian life is means full of sufferings. It's a wrong thinking. They think that God is the cause for all the sickness. God may be given the sickness for some reason. God may give the sickness so that I will draw closer to him. My God, if he really thinks like that, every human being in this world will become sick because he wants everyone to draw closer to him. So God is not going to give you sickness so that you will draw closer. Actually, it is a man's tendency, you know, when we get into kind of a problem and trouble, we immediately think about God, we seek God, we pray. But you don't need to get sick in order to seek God and pray. While you are strong and healthy, when you are successful, you can still seek him. So when we were, you know, beaten in life, when we are experiencing failure, you know, it's a human tendency to seek God. But God is not giving a sickness so that he will seek him, you know, that will make him such a worst selfish person. And I know that my God is not like that. My God is a good God. He's a compassionate God. He loves you. He always wish the best for you. If at all there is one person who wish the best for you, it is your heavenly Father. Every good gifts, perfect gift come from Father above. Book of James tells us. Every good gifts, every perfect gifts comes from Father up. If you know evil Father how to give good gifts to your children, how much more your heavenly Father give good gifts to his children. So he is not going to, you know, give you sickness. I want to tell you, healing is God's will for you. It is God's desire. It is God's plan. It is part of a salvation. The word salvation, so meaning, you know, sozo, meaning, you know, health and wholeness and well-being. So it is a part of your salvation. It's a whole package, you know. Sozo means, you know, you are healed emotionally, physically. You will feel peace. You are at ease, you know, absolute wholeness. So healing is God's will. You know, God is not a, you know, kind of a schizophrenic. You know, one time he heals, one time he gives sickness. He himself gives sickness and he himself will try to heal you. My God, he's not playing such kind of games, my brothers and sisters. I want to tell you. He's not playing such kind of games like that. God only gives you healing. He's not giving you sickness. I know that, you know, some of you may try to support some scriptures to prove that, you know, God is also giving sickness. And I want to tell you, for past, like, you know, from the year 1999 onwards, I'm studying the scriptures. 1999. I'm fully dedicated. I'm fully passionate. And I have no other job than studying scripture and teaching and preaching the scripture for pastor, you know, as a full-time pastor for 15 years. And even before that, I used to preach and teach. So I want to tell you, God, it is God's will that you should be healed. This God wants you to be well. I want to tell you that. Healing is a God's will for you. There is no change in that. So having a right thoughts about God, you know, it's very important. If you think that God only gives you sickness, it's very difficult. If you think that God is giving you sickness for some purpose, he wants to teach you some lessons, it's very sad, you know, you don't have a right opinion about God. You know, God's word is sufficient, you know, his Holy Spirit is sufficient to teach you so many things. He don't need to give you sickness and give you cancer, give you TB, give you HIV, you know, to teach you some lessons. See, when we become sick, you know, we may learn some lessons like, you know, okay, I have not taken care of my health properly. I have not slept. I have not eaten proper nutritious food. So therefore, I become sick now. So I have to be careful now. I have to sleep well. I have to eat well. And I have to do some exercise. I have to take care of my body. We may learn some lessons, but, you know, don't tell me God is, you know, teaching you some lessons. That shows that, you know, you have a wrong thought about God. God is not, you know, giving you any sickness. So wrong thoughts about God, wrong thoughts about you. You know, people, especially Christians, you know, they feel so guilty. They feel so condemned because they are constantly living in the framework of right and wrong. They are, you know, constantly living, you know, under the framework of right and wrong. They are constantly, you know, eating from the fruit from the tree of knowledge, good and evil. But we have to partake, you know, from the tree of life, which can produce life. Most of the time, okay, this is not right, this is not wrong, this is right, this is wrong. You know, we are constantly, you know, fluctuating our mind between this framework, right and wrong. So somewhere we believe that I have done something wrong, that's why, you know, all the sickness is coming upon me. God is punishing me now. Because I have done a lot of wrong things in my life. Now God is punishing me. I'm here to tell you, God is not punishing you. My God is a God who forgives you. You are fully forgiven. That's what I want to tell you. You are fully forgiven. He's a merciful God. I'm telling you, he's merciful to you. He's gracious to you. He has forgiven you. You are washed. You are clean. You are complete. The blood of Jesus washing your hearts and minds. But the problem is the Christian people are constantly living in a guilty consciousness, constantly living in a sense of condemnations. I read in a book, you know, the true story, one doctor in America having a clinic. So the medical doctor observed that whenever there is a revival meeting in that city and his clinic is full of a lot of people, you know, sick people. When he examined them, actually, they don't have any kind of disease, but they were experiencing some kind of pain and discomfort. So after, you know, a kind of a deeper examination, they come to know that these people attended the revival meeting In that revival meeting, the preacher is, you know, preaching, you know, a lot of condemnations. Like, you know, saying that, you know, if you're not going to repent, you're going to end up in hell and you're going to be burned forever and ever and ever. God is angry with you. God is going to send judgment. God is going to do this and God is going to do that. They portrayed the angry God. And they told that you are a sinner. And, you know, you are deserving for all this kind of punishments. I see sometimes it's very sad, you know, how we made this gospel as a kind of a threatening message. It's I feel so sad. So immediately somebody will ask me, oh, then we should not talk about sin. We should not talk about repentance. Yes, you can talk about repentance. You can deal with sin, you know, without even talking about it. You may be wondering, how come? And we do that. The more you are keep on talking about sin, people become sin conscious. The more they become sin conscious, they will continue to live in sin. But we preach about the goodness of God. And Romans chapter 2, Bible tells us, goodness of God leads us into repentance. So the more I preach about God's goodness, people will lead into repentance. The goodness of God leads us into repentance. One more time, I want to tell you, it is the goodness of God. And not only that, when I tell people you are clean, you are forgiven, you are righteous, when they develop the righteousness consciousness, they are going to overcome sin. But the more I keep on preaching about the sin, the more I focusing on the sin, and the sin consciousness is going to expand, and they are going to live constantly sinning. So I want to tell you, you know, this doctor observed that whenever there is a revival meeting, there are a lot of people, you know, become sick and coming to that clinic. I'm telling you, you know, most of them, it is the Christian people who live in guilt and condemnation, no rest in their heart and no peace in their life. They think that they, as a Christian, they were destined for sufferings. They believe that in this world only suffering is there. Only when we die and go to heaven, we are going to experience the bliss. But now, you know, only suffering, they think like that. No. Heaven on earth is God's plan. Our Father, I Lord be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. You know, it is God's desire that he wants to make this earth like a heaven. If you are going to be healed in heaven, it is God's desire that you should be healed in the earth also. That's a God's desire, my brothers. It's a God's desire, my sisters, that you should be healed, you should be healthy. Hallelujah. So it's a wrong thoughts, guilty consciousness, condemnations, you know, produce a lot of sickness. So today I want to tell you that I want to apply the blood of Jesus. Jesus carried all our sins upon him on the cross. Jesus carried all our guilt so that we can experience his righteousness, so that we can experience his peace in our life. He carried all our sickness so that we can receive healing in our body. By his stripes we were healed, the Bible tells us. He became sin so that we can become righteousness. So if you're feeling, you know, guilty and your heart is condemning you, I want to tell you, receive the blood of Jesus. Allow the blood of Jesus to wash your hearts and minds. Receive his peace. You are forgiven. You know, God is merciful. God is not angry with you. Don't condemn yourself, but come to the throne of grace boldly so that you may receive help in due time. The problem with Christian is when they read a book about prayer, they condemn themselves. So see that people are praying a lot. I'm not praying. You know, they condemn themselves. The more you feel guilty, the more you feel condemned, you are not going to come out of the problem. You are going to repeat the same sins and same mistake again and again. The more you allow the blood of Jesus to cleanse you and wash your mind, you're going to come out of the stronghold of sins. So don't feel condemned. This guilty consciousness and the condemnation brings a lot of sickness. Then another thing, jealousy. We are not able to be happy about other success. We are feeling jealous of other success. We are feeling unhappy for other people's success. You know what you expect for others, you know, it will happen to you. If you want somebody to go down, we will go down. Wish the best for everyone. Wish the success for everyone. Let everyone enjoy the success. Let everyone go up in their life. Let everyone experience tremendous blessing. Never intend evil for anyone in your heart. It is going to bring us down. And not only is going to bring us down, it is going to cause a lot of sickness, jealous, bitterness. There are people who have a lot of bitterness. They cannot able to forgive. They refuse to forgive. They are so hard-hearted. They are so stubborn that, you know, they refuse to forgive. They will tell me, you know, Pastor, I am not Jesus Christ to forgive. Jesus will tell to forgive. Jesus may forgive, but I am not Jesus Christ. My God, I know that you are not Jesus Christ. You don't need to tell me. I know who you are. But I am here to help you. If you want to experience a lot of health and wholeness in your body, you should release all the bitterness. Bitterness is like a poison, you know, drinking poison. There are a lot of people who are sick in their life because of unforgiveness. Take a time to forgive others. Forgive your husband, forgive your wife, forgive your children, forgive your parents, forgive your brothers and sisters. Forgive your friends, forgive your relatives, forgive your co-workers. You know, whoever you have to forgive, take some time. Whoever you are angry with, take some time to forgive. Release them. You will have a lot of peace. You know, it's an art of releasing. You know, the more you release people, you know, the more you will able to receive a lot of health and healing and peace and joy in your life. But there are people who are very stubborn. No matter what you tell, Pastor, I cannot forgive that person. Don't forgive. I don't care. You don't want to forgive? Don't forgive. You want to keep on hold the grudge? You can hold on. I don't have any problem. But that is going to affect your health. That is going to affect your physical health. It is going to affect your emotions. It is going to affect your mental health. There are people, you know, having a lot of mental disease these days because of unforgiveness. So forgive others. Forgive yourself. Sometimes, you know, you condemn yourself for not doing well in your life. Condemn yourself for experiencing failure. Don't condemn yourself. Love yourself. Learn to forgive yourself. Learn to love yourself. God loves you. God forgives you. So you have to love. You have to forgive yourself. The other thing which, you know, creates lot of sickness in people is, you know, criticizing. My God, you know, criticism is the worst thing we can do it. 12 verse 1, you know, and if you read the number chapter 12, I think, if you read it, you know, Miriam, you know, criticized Moses because Moses married an Ethiopian woman. The problem is that she's an Ethiopian woman. That's the problem. You know, I sometimes feel bad, you know, still people are thinking about the caste and the language, you know, what caste you belong to, what is the language you are belong to. Okay, I'm Tamil, they are Malayali. So we don't like Tamil people, we don't like Malayalis. What is this? We are all human, we are all God's children. As a human being, we must love every human being and we have to help every human being. One human has to help another human. As a human being, you have to love others. As a child of God, you should believe that every human is a child of God and you should be able to love them. Miriam, you know, I'm surprised that, you know, Miriam was a godly woman in the Bible, but she criticized Moses because he married an Ethiopian woman. Very sad. And you know what? She received a leprosy. She was struck with a leprosy. Criticizing others. We must ask God to forgive us if we have a criticizing heart and mind. If we are a person who criticizes a lot, you know, we should ask God to forgive us. We should have changed our mind. If you look at people and believe that they are good, they will be good to you. If you think that people are bad, and you will experience a lot of bad things from people. If you think that I'm a good person, you know, whatever I will do, you know, it will be good to you. If you think that I'm a bad person, whatever I'll do, it will look bad to you. it's all depends on your perception, your interpretations, your framework in your mind. So believe, you know, God is good. Believe that everyone is good. That's what I want to tell you today. So don't criticize anyone. You know, unforgiveness, criticism, all these things, you know, produce a lot of, you know, bad health, bad emotions, bad feelings, it's a lot of anger. So I want to tell you, release all the anger. Forgive everyone. You know what? You will experience a lot of peace in your life. These are the wrong thoughts, you know, guilt and condemnation, unforgiveness, jealous, criticizing others, believing that God gives sickness. These are the wrong thoughts, you know, is the root cause for a lot of sickness. Believe that God is good and believe that God loves you and believe that, you know, everyone is good. People will respond to you the way you look at them. If you look at people like everyone is a cheater, and you will be experiencing a lot, you know, in the same line of thought. A lot of people will cheat you. If you learn to trust people, you know, a lot of people will work, you know, behave trustworthy. So your wrong thoughts, you know, leads into wrong feelings. And wrong feelings create the reality. Whatever you are feeling, you know, you're going to manifest. I keep telling you, feeling is the key. Wrong thoughts produce the bad feelings, and bad feelings, you know, creates bad events in your life. That's why Bible talks about good feelings, you know, love, joy, and peace. Why? If you are in love, if you are in joy, if you are in peace, a lot of good things will happen in your life. But if you are angry, if you are bitter, if you are in unforgiveness, full of hurt, and it's going to produce a lot of bad things in your life. Forgive everyone. Take some time. Just sit, you know. Imagine all the people who hurt you, who made you angry. Imagine those people. Just take a time. Okay, I forgive this person. I forgive that person. Take a time and finally tell to yourself, forgive, you know. I forgive myself. And believe that God also forgiven you already. So in Mark chapter 11 verse 24, Bible tells us, when you pray, believe that you received it, then you will have it. So first of all, you have to believe that you received it. So how to do this? You know, it's like this. You know, I want to tell you like a kind of a practical tips or a practical exercise I can give you. Take a Bible and read some scripture concerning healing. Say, for example, by his stripes I'm healed. So just read that scripture and ponder upon that scripture for some time. Meditate upon the scripture. Soak yourself upon that scripture. Then after some times, you know, then begin to imagine that you are healed. Imagine, you know, look into your mind's eyes that you are healed, you are strong, you are full of energy, you are able to do the things which you are not able to do before. You are looking so whole, you are looking so beautiful, you are looking so strong. Begin to see those things. And, you know, when you begin to have such kind of thoughts that can produce different feelings, you know, you feel that, you know, you are totally healed. You have to bring that feeling into your body that you are full of healing, full of energy, full of strength, and you are healed. You are so happy. You are so joyful. People in the world, they got this. They are doing a practice session, you know, act as if. The session is called act as if. You know, whatever, you know, you want to achieve it, act as if you are already achieved it. It's a very famous thing in the secular world, but church is somehow missing it. Church is always acting as if God is not good. Church is always acting as if God will never do anything. Church always acting as if their prayer will never be answered. They're always unhappy. They're always sad. They go run around telling everyone, please pray for me, pray for me, pray for me. But Bible tells us when you pray, believe that you received it. You already received it. Imagine, feel that you are already healed. Imagine that you are already wealthy. Imagine that you are already strong. Imagine that you are able to do everything. Imagine that you are looking so beautiful. Imagine that you are looking younger and younger every day. Imagine that you are stronger and stronger. See what is going to happen in your life. So wrong thoughts, wrong feelings, wrong actions causes sickness. Now how to reverse it? Right thoughts, right feelings, right action combined with prayer is very powerful. It can produce some tremendous healings in your life. So with this, I want to close. I want to pray for you, my brothers and sisters.